evening students, welcome back to the class. In last class you have studied about Bhakti movement. So today we are going to study about the Bhakti movement in North India. Students, you have already studied about the Bhakti movement, which had its beginning in Tamil Nadu. Later it spread to North India. So today we are going to study the contributions made by Kabir Das, Guru Nanak and Mirabai to the Bhakti movement. Let's see the contribution of Kabir Das to Bhakti movement. He tried to promote brotherhood between Hinduism and Islam. His aim was to propagate a religion of love, uniting people of all castes and religions. He strongly opposed all discriminations on the basis of caste, religion, class, family and wealth. He focused on the unity of humanity, opposed caste system and untouchability. He rejected idol worship, pilgrimage and bath in holy rivers. The ideas of Kabir developed through discussions and deliberations on the basis of the Bhakti Sufi traditions. Okay, next, let's see the Guru Nanak's contributions to Bhakti movement. Guru Nanak was a preceptor or instructor who focused on the ideas of monotheism. Here, monotheism means the belief that there is only one God. He tried to combine the ideas of Hinduism and Islam. He was a spokesman of the ideals of religious tolerance and universal brotherhood. He opposed the rituals of both Hinduism and Islam. He said that one has to maintain purity in the character and behavior to reach God. He forcefully opposed idol worship and pilgrimages. He promoted a middle path that permitted ritual life along with the responsibility of a householder. The prayer songs known as Shabad were the contribution of Nanak. He strongly opined that all human beings are equal and hence there is no need of caste distinction among them. He instructed his followers to have food from the common kitchen. He also instructed that the people from all castes could take food from the langar. Langar means kitchen. The ideas of Nanak later led to the emergence of Sikhism. Okay students, let's study about the women representation in Bhakti movement. Many women were attracted to the Bhakti movement. Poetess Mirabai of Rajasthan was the famous among them. She was a devotee of Krishna. She composed a number of bhajanas. All these were prayer songs addressing Lord Krishna. The songs of Mirabai are recited by the people of Gujarat and Rajasthan even today. Mirabai did not have a band of followers or a group of her own. Yet, she was considered as a source of inspiration even after centuries. Besides Mirabai, the presence of women was visible in the Bhakti movement in different parts of India. Like Ladad of Kashmir, Bahinabai of Maharashtra, Akka Mahadevi of Karnataka, Andal and Karakkal Ammayar of Tamil Nadu were the prominent among them. Okay friends, let's see the results of the Bhakti movement. Bhakti movement evolved with the aim of dedication to God. It created qualitative changes in the Indian social system. The propagators of the Bhakti cult through their words and songs maintained that everyone was equal in front of God. This strengthened the concept of social equality against caste discriminations. The idea of gender equality also began to take shape. The idea of social equality got wide popularity since the movement was led by the low caste people like Tirupanna Alvar, Kabir and Ladend. The regional languages were developed and the evil practices were questioned. Okay students, hope that you have understood all about the Bhakti movement in North India. Read your textbook thoroughly. If you have any doubt, you can ask. So be happy and safe at your home. See you in the next class. Thank you.